coming to you from our GIS studios. I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your Media News Brief. The Ministry of Tourism, Information and Broadcasting, Culture and Creative Industries signaled the commencement of the 2019 cruise season by hosting a high-level meeting with key stakeholders within the cruise sector, including private and public sector agencies. The primary focus of the meeting was to share the concerns of stakeholders on issues relating to the sector, as well as to generate mechanisms to address those issues. The Starkey Herring Foundation, in collaboration with the Department of Health and Wellness, will be hosting the third National Herring Mission on Sunday, October 13th and Monday, October 14th, 2019, at the National Cultural Center from 8 a.m. daily. During this period, screening and fitting of herring devices will be performed. The foundation will be providing herring aids free of cost, as well as a lifetime supply of batteries and aftercare support. The Phase 1 and Phase 2 missions is expected to cater to approximately 600 persons. Prior to the screening, all persons with herring impairments will be required to have their herring tested at the Viewfort and Lacklery Wellness Centers. Therefore, the Department of Health and Wellness is appealing to all persons with herring difficulties to call the Viewfort and Lacklery Wellness Centers for an appointment. His Excellency Anton Edmonds, Permanent Representative of St. Lucia to the OAS, in his capacity as Chair of CARICOM, Caucus of Ambassadors in Washington, D.C., on October 1st, joined OAS Secretary General Luis Almagro and the head of the Chilean Agency for International Development Cooperation, Juan Pablo Lira, for the signing of an OAS Chile CARICOM agreement. The agreement, which ushers in the second phase of a scholarship training program, will benefit members of the Caribbean community CARICOM in the field of disaster resilience. The government of Chile in 2017 initially pledged US$250,000 to education and training of CARICOM nationals in disaster preparedness. In this second phase, the government of Chile has pledged an additional contribution of US$150,000 for 2019-2020. Chile's support will allow for a continued partnership with education institutions throughout CARICOM member states, including the Sir Arthur Lewis Community College in St. Lucia. The course will specifically focus on disaster risk management and resilience building. This has been your Media News Brief. Thank you for watching.